Hi everyone. Today we're going to do a mortis and tenon joint. We start out with the mortising. So for mortising we need a mortis chisel, a square, a mortis gauge, mallet, and you need two clamps to hold down to the bench. Now before we get started, we'll talk a little minute about safety. So safety. It's important to wear the appropriate PPE or personal protective equipment when doing any job. Okay, safety glasses, dust mask when needed, okay, and your overalls and of course safety boots. Not necessary for doing this particular job, but it's always important to wear the right safety gear for the right job. Okay, right, we'll make a start. Okay, we start off by marking out the mortise, so we get our square. To use the square, we put our thumb on the inside, fingers on the outside, squash the square into position, index finger on the top, slide the square up to the point you want to draw the line. Use the timber itself as your measurement, rather than measuring with a tape, and draw in your second line. Bring the lines around from one side of the piece of timber to the next and draw in your guidelines. Next thing to use is the mortise gauge. When using the mortise gauge, you have two pins pointing towards yourself. Pivot them around on the lower line to make two holes. That stops the mortise gauge when you're pushing the forward from running too far. Again, bring it up to the top line. With the two pins facing you, pivot the pins around till they hit the top line, and the same time as pushing in the gauge, push forward and the gauge will stop at the two pin holes down below. Use your pencil mark then to mark in your lines. To do the far side, because working with timber you always work from both sides. So again, two pins towards yourself on the bottom line, pivot them around, make two little holes, bring the mortise gauge to the top line with the two pins facing yourself, pivot it around till it hits the line, at the same time as pushing it in, push it forward and the mortise gauge will stop at the two holes that you've drawn in, marked in first. Again, use your pencil to draw in your parallel lines. And your X's indicate your waist. Right, next stage. You clamp your piece of timber to the vise to stop it from moving. Like so. Again, I'll take a moment to talk about safety when using a chisel. There are three safety rules while using a chisel. If you obey them, you'll never cut yourself with a chisel. The first rule is always have the timber clamped down or in the vise. In this case, we're clamping it down so that the timber doesn't burst out underneath. Second rule is always have your two hands behind the chisel. So never have your hand in front of the blade at any time. So your two hands behind the chisel, you can't stick it in yourself. And the third rule is never chisel towards yourself. So if you obey those, go through those three rules again, if you look with the chisel, it will bounce back to the line. Hold the chisel straight, give it two taps with the mallet. Again, bring it around to the far side. And again, the straight part of the chisel, or the flat part of the chisel, 1 millimeter from the line, strike it twice with the mallet, and it'll bounce back to the line. Next stage is to hold the chisel so that the flat part is facing upwards, but the chisel is at a slight angle. Strike the chisel twice and pull forward and the piece falls out. Now the last strike, turn the chisel the opposite way just to get the piece out. And you just keep repeating that process over and over again. Flat part of the chisel on the line, chisel up vertical, two strikes, straight part chisel on the line, chisel up vertical, three strikes. Hold the chisel so that the flat part or straight part of the chisel is facing up. Hold it at a slight angle, two strikes, hold the chisel forward, and the piece breaks. And the last one, the opposite direction. Now this method stops the timber from splitting along the grain. So, repeat this. Using this method, you quickly move down through the mortise. Now it's important at this stage to remember that when you're working with timber, you always work from both sides of the timber. So you don't go down any more than halfway and then become halfway from the other side. So last row. Turn it about. Again, remember your safety rules when using the chisel. Always have your timber clamped down. Two hands behind the chisel at all times and never chisel towards yourself. So we have the timber now reversed and we can see our waste by the X's that we've drawn on previously. And we repeat the process all over again. So straight or flat part of the chisel, 1 millimeter from the line, hold it up vertical, two taps. And the reason why I say two taps is because if you hit it too hard, the chisel gets stuck in the timber and then you can't move it. So hold the chisel with the flat part facing up and hold the chisel at a slight angle, two taps and pull forward. After a couple of rows, we should meet up from the mortise on the far side. There we go, we've broken through. Now the mortise itself is one of the most common ways of joining timber together. It's also used for mortise locks on your doors at home. So it's important to do a nice clean mortise job. Now look at my two hands behind the chisel at all times. And clean it. I don't need to hold the timber like this because it's clamped down. And there's my mortise. This is a good indicator of where a mortise and tenon joint is used. Okay, so you can see there's no nails or screws holding anything together. You have the mortise, as you can see here, and the tenon is the piece of timber coming through. And then we have two wedges holding it all in place. So no need for screws or nails. And again, on the reverse side, we have our mortise and our two wedges. And as a result then, we have a trestle completed without using any screws or nails.